go through this one more time, shall we?
Look, I'm terribly sorry.
Stand up straight when I'm talking to you.
Sorry.
You're a sorry specimen. You really are. What are you?
A sorry specimen.
That's enough here to put you away for years. Number one, loitering.
But I live here. I was watching television.
How do you get clever with me? Save your highly unlikely explanations for the judge. Two, attempted murder.
What?
Could I draw your attention to the vase of flowers carefully placed by this open window?
So?
Does the term hay fever mean anything to you? Or has it not occurred to you that the pollen from said flowers will drift down onto Streatham High Street and straight up the nostril of a long-distance lorry driver, causing him to sneeze violently and lose control of the vehicle, thus ploughing into a queue of schoolchildren waiting for the number 14 bus, 15 dead, 27 in intensive care, and extra strain put on an already overburdened health service?
Oh. I have no idea.
That's the trouble with you young people today. You just don't think.
I'll move them. Hang on, they're plastic.
Oh, fraud! Can you think of any reason why I shouldn't throw the book at you?
Because you're my fiancé.
Not yet, I'm not. Nor am I likely to be if you don't buck up your ideas. And anyway, you haven't asked me yet.
Rene, my love. Would you consider?
Not now. We'll talk about it this evening. I've got to go and make an arrest. There's a woman down there carrying a frozen chicken.
So?
I wonder about you sometimes, Terry. That's not her Sunday lunch. That's an offensive weapon. She could chuck that through a jeweller's window, smash and grab. I better hurry.
Will you come round later?
Perhaps. Though why I should bother with someone with no job, no prospects and no money is beyond me. Not now. I'm on duty. You know, once I let go, I'm a smouldering volcano of passion with a lust that can't be quenched.
Well, so you keep saying, Rene, but I've only got your word for it. Couldn't I have a little preview?
No, you can't, Terry. Once the lava starts spurting, I lose control. If only I could trust myself in your embrace. But I can't. Get a job.
Bye. Don't worry. I'll think of something. I know a way of making some money. And one that doesn't involve going out to work. Hello, evening Echo. Yeah, I'd like to place an ad in your flat share column, please. Now, wanted. Professional person to share luxury apartment. With suit gentleman with no sense of smell. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, they'd never let me on. I would have been here earlier, only someone threw a frozen chicken through the window.
They did.
If you please, a frozen chicken through the window of Ratner's. I did manage to get this.
Who are you? What's all this?
How do you do? My name's Julian, and I'm making an entrance. As is my wont, that is how you make an entrance. You don't just shuffle about in your beige clothing. People want elegance, cheekbones, good wholesome family entertainment, and the occasional homosexual mincing about in full makeup. And I'm not talking about David Dimbleby.
Anyway, what can I do for you?
I'm your new flatmate.
Blimey, that was quick. I've only just phoned the paper.
Well, I can't afford to hang around, you know. I'm a homeless Channel 4 celebrity.
Channel 4 celebrity? Isn't that a contradiction in terms?
What do you mean? I do put it about a bit, and I'm not averse to trying any channel.
I don't suppose this flat'll be grand enough for you.
Oh, no, not too quickly, please. I like a bit of rough now and then. Mind you, I do find your three-piece aesthetically displeasing. And I don't think much of your sofa either. Come on in, lads, please. Listen to that.
Who's this lot?
This is Terps and Tickles, decorators to the rich and famous.
Rich and the famous? Like who?
Well, Mr. Terps, I believe. Didn't you have a hand in Nanette Newman's interior?
Yes, indeed I did, sir.
Well, see what you could do with this room, please, would you?
Right, lads. Let's get started.
I'm not very happy. You can't just come in here and chuck my stuff out.
I'm sorry, but one more glance at your coffee table and I'd hyperventilate. Now then, where's my room?
Now hold it right there. You know what you can do?
Here's 3 years' rent in advance.
You can take the bed by the door.
I thought you might. Bye
bye.
Bye bye.
Say. Oh, this is lovely.
Oh, well. I see you've left my off decent.
There's only one thing missing in this room. There we are.
Isn't it amazing the way his moustache seems to follow you around the room?
Don't mind if I test the bed, do you? It's obviously been well broken in. Get off me, you brute.
What are you doing?
I'm practicing.
Well, I'll leave you to it then. I'll make a cup of tea, eh?
Oh, yes, please. Mine's a red zinger.
I'm not surprised the way you carry on.
Cooey. Is it rude?
Yeah. Sugar?
Just call me Julian.
Sugar.
Well, actually, I'm a two-lump man myself.
Now you've settled in, first things first. If you're going to stay here, you have to abide by the rules of the flat.
You'll be as strict with me as you like.
Now, first of all, no smoking.
Fair enough.
No dogs after 8 o'clock.
You're a hard man.
Thirdly, no women.
It's an outrage. I'm a red-blooded man.
No women are said, and no women I mean.
Well, I don't know how I manage.
I'm afraid you just...
I'll get cramped, that's what'll happen. Actually, I have domestic guidelines of my own. Yeah. Yes, I do, as a matter of fact. Every Tuesday, I have to wander around in the nude. Helps the skin breathe. And I rise at 11. And I'll expect a warm croissant and a ring donut before I so much as open my mouth.
Yeah, well, a word about the local facilities.
Dorothy Perkins.
Just over the road.
Are there any discotheques around here?
Well, there is one. I think Friday is the night you'll be interested in.
That's tonight. I'll unpack my Diamante bum bag.
That suits me very well, because tonight I've got my girlfriend, Rene, coming round.
Oh, yes. Well, I can always go another night, then.
No, I'd rather you weren't here, because it's a very special occasion. Tonight, I'm going to propose to her.
Well, I don't know that I like the sound of that. If you don't want to rush into these things, don't be impetuous.
No.
Maybe I could introduce you to one of my show business friends. Do you know Fluella Benjamin?
Look, it's nothing to do with you. I'm going to propose to her, and that's that.
Well, you'll be sorry.
No, I won't. And if you're staying in tonight, I don't want you disturbing us.
Don't worry about me. I shall be as quiet as the annual general meeting of the Mike Smith Appreciation Society.
Okay, well, I'm going down the shop to get some stuff for tonight.
Pick me up a bag of nuts, would you? Only I like a late night Brazil. And some of those thin, dark chocolates.
After dinner mints?
Only if there's nothing on the telly.
Well, the kitchen's over here. Help yourself. But whatever you do, don't touch that oven. It's of great sentimental value. Rene, my beloved, gave me that oven.
Don't worry, I quite understand. Household appliances have played quite an important part in my history. I know that model. My mother met my father in one of those. And as a matter of fact, I lost my virginity under an eye-level grill. Which I rather, Randy, meat pie.
Was it that pastry?
Was by the time I'd finished.
Yeah, I'll see you later.
All right, well, Watch out for any strange men.
I will.
I hear around the back of the station is a good place. Hello? Hello, is that New Zealand? Could you put me through to the dressing room of the All Blacks rugby team, please? Yes, I'll hold. I'm an expert. Hello, Rupert. Hello, Rupert, it's Julian here. Remember me? The nightclub in Marbella? That's right. 6 vodkas and a bar of soap. How are you? Did you ever find that hamster? I remember spending 3/4 of an hour trying to coax him out with a lettuce leaf. I felt a fool. Anyway, Rupert, the reason I rang is I've still got your bicycle pump. That's right. Now, I could send it back to you or I could keep it here. Only I can always find a use for it this end. Once I've wiped the lemon curd off it. Okay, Rupert. Okay. Right. Back to your bath now. Give my regards to the rest of the scrum. Bye-bye, Rupert. Bye-bye. Yes, I will. Twice a day. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Happy days. Now then, what shall I do? I think I'll wipe down a few surfaces. Hasn't been done for a while, this. There we are. It's much better. I don't see why I shouldn't clean his oven, do you? It's begging me for a squirt and a wipe. Just a gentle rub down. I've never had any complaints before. There we are. It's come up lovely. They'll thank me for that later. Oh, no, Hunters, what am I going to do? I've blown up Terry's oven and I'm a complete mess. If you think I'm getting my squeezy out at this juncture, you're very much mistaken. If only I had someone else to blame it on. Someone from the audience, perhaps. A contrary love. Hello?
Hello.
What are you? Westminster. You work for Westminster?
Yeah.
Westminster what?
Westminster Council.
Council? Oh, doing what?
we issue parking tickets to...
Michael, could I trouble you, Michael?
Sure.
Right, come with me. It's going to be quite simple. The lovely Michael, ladies and gentlemen. Have you got a nice office with a window and everything?
Yeah.
Sorry?
Yes.
Right, now, while I explain to Michael exactly what... I'm going to call you Bob, by the way. Much easier, Bob. While I explain to Bob what's expected of him, we'll take a quick commercial break. Thank you. Now, Bob.